Today we are going to see about 2 marks in the history 7th lesson, urban changes during the British period. Okay, that is a lesson name. So urban area. So what is an urban area? So urban means what? Urban means cities, nagaram. Okay, so an urban area is one that has a high population density. Yeah, so in the city side only having the so much of population. Okay, in the village side there are less population only there. So an urban area is one that has a high population because all the people wants to go to city side, because in the city side only they need everything. Okay, so population density engaged in occupation, other food production, living in highly built environment. Yeah. So an urban area is one that has a high population density, engaged in occupations, also that food production, also all the people wants to live in the some apartment. So living in a highly built environment. So this is a urban area. Second question. Hilly areas were distinctive features of colonial urban development. Why? Okay, hilly areas were distinctive features of colonial urban development. Why? So hilly areas, which means Malay Bangani area. Okay, so hill station like that. So answer is the British coming from a cool temperate climate. Yeah. So the England there was a cool climate. So the British coming from a cool temperate climate found the hill station protect from the hot weather and epidemics. So okay, so hilly areas, which means what? Hill station. Okay, Annamari place. So the British coming from that place. So okay, the British coming from a cool temperate climate. So they came to India. They have to found out one cooling place. Okay, therefore they found the hill station to protect from the hot weather and epidemics. So they built up the alternative capitals in cool areas. Yeah, like that. Suppose in Tamil Nadu we have a cool areas, means Ooty, Kodaikanal, like that. So in the Mari, they built up the alternative capital in some places, cool areas. So highly hill areas were distinctive features of colonial urban development. Yeah, highly hilly areas, highly romba aita irukku. So highly hilly areas were distinctive features of urban development, colonial urban development. Name the 3 presidency cities. So presidency cities, which means post, president post. Okay, in the late 18th century, Calcutta, Bombay, Madras, Rosas presidency cities. Because in that place is Calcutta, Bombay, Madras. In that place only the trading, the business was very very top. Okay, business, trading, in the 3 areas, Calcutta, Bombay, Madras only having the so much of trading places. Okay, also in that particular place only British got so many profit. So name the 3 presidency cities in the late 18th century, Calcutta, Bombay, Madras. Okay. State any 4 reasons for the new trend of urbanization in the 19th century. Urbanization, which means if you have one village, I have to urbanize that village, means so I have to cut the trees and then build the companies, factories. Okay, so many apartments like that. That is urbanization. The cast for the new trend of urbanization in the 19th century were opening of Suez Canal, introduction of steam navigation, construction of railways, canal and harbors. This is the first step. So first of all, they opening the Suez Canal and then steam navigation, construction of railways. Railway, they construct the railways and also harbors. And also, yeah, just now I said that growth of factory industries, etc. Write short note on cantonment towns. Cantonment towns, which means what? Army people places. Okay, that place is called. So, cantonment towns. Okay, so first of all, the British needed one strong military camp. Okay, in that after came to the India, the British needed one strong military camp. So they built the one town. That town name is called Cantonment. Okay, so in that Cantonment towns, only army people began to live in these places. Okay, gradually they grown up into city. They were grown up into a city. Example, Kanpur, Lahore, yeah, like that. Now look at the Kashmir, Ladakh places. That is the cantonment towns. What were the regions covered in the Madras Presidency during British regime? The regions covered in the Madras Presidency. What are the regions? What are the places are covered in the Madras Presidency during the British regime? Modern day Tamil Nadu, the Lakshadweep Island, Northern Kerala, Rayalaseema, Coastal Andhra, District of Karnataka, various District of Southern Odisha. That's it. So read again these two marks.